Lake. Hi, Sprite. Oh my, I cannot with this game. Are you gonna pull for Hazel later? I hope you don't get Ningguang and Toma. Oh no, I haven't pulled yet. Oh my god, I'm gonna die! Oh no. Dukesh. Bye, he's so cool. I did my temple, I got them. Nice. Ah! Woo! I was given the other rate ups in my single tent. Oh. Welp. Here goes nothing. No Hazel or Klee. Uh-oh. Okay. Wait. Okay. Do it on Klee's banner. Hi, Nexa! Please be Hazel. Please. Another one. Give me something. Nar. I'm at 40, I think. Yeah, 40. Okay, one more. One more, and I'm giving up. Oh no. Okay. Who are we thinking this is? Who are we thinking this is? I'm scared now. This is early. D-Luke? Are we getting D-Luke constellations? Oh wow! I won a 50-50! That's a first! What the hell? I mean, I wanted her, so I guess that works. I guess. I guess so. Okay, fuck it, I'm doing an MMR. Imagine if I get 2 5 stars in a row. Yeah, that's not possible. Do they not want to give me a... I hate it here. I hate it here. I freaking hate it here. I hate it here. There we go! Let's go! Yay! Ha Okay, I low key want this. If it's not showing up, it's okay. I don't know if I should buy the Diluc skin. It's $40. Oh, what is this? Physical bonus. Oh, that's Fischl's spell? Ooh, she has a bow now, and I'm out of primos now. Fook. Toma C2. I'm gonna go current now. Congrats on Bo. You'll get him. Do one more. One more temple. You never know. This was not planned. I don't have a weapon for her. Fine, but I'm gonna lose my guarantee watch. Wait, what's your pity right now? What weapon do I give her? Oh, there we go. I'm sorry, Yinfei. That's so cute! Bye. I'm keeping it till next Harbinger. Well, that's not gonna be until what? Scaramouche? And like, who knows when we're meeting him again? 40 to 50. Yeah, no. He's a 4-star. You'll get him eventually. Da 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 da. Oh no, I have to farm for her too. Sag. Bye, Sprite. Tignari. I guess. Bye, bye, Sprite. That's so cute, Totoko. I don't have artifacts either. Physical clee. I don't have Crimson. Leo. Oh, I don't want to find the worm. Missions first.
Mission的目标是听凭风影，刀姐。 Oh.
Boing, boing, boing. Oh no. Kidding. Oh, that was useless. Oh, 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 oh. Huh? There's one more? Where? Oh. You're so cute. Oh no! Please don't fly. Never mind. Could you?
Or悠闲一下也不错。哒哒哒，嗡嗡，向着星辰与山。
Am I not done my commissions? Oh! Oh. Heh. Okay, I'll be right back. Okay. Oh, it's an Inazuma. Da-da-da! Wait a second. What? Was this a bad idea? Probably. Hey. Oh.
叫风元万叶的人，他子浩，都用单手剑。我还听说他有风元素力的神之眼，和你没关系。算了，看你也不知道，浪费时间。这人到底怎么回事？就知道拿怪怪的道乱挥，还莫名其妙的，连句道歉都不讲。
Paimon's voice in Chinese is not as annoying.
<笑>以防万一，我们还是要赶快通知万叶，让他小心提防。啊，什么想法？特殊的关系？你是想说他认识万叶吗？好像是有点。
但大家的招数看起来都差不多吧，这也说明不了什么。总之，我们快去给万叶提个醒吧，免得他遇到危险。A strange and friendless road. To Rito. Kazuha, coming. What the hell? Shortcut.
Hey, 你好，你知道万叶在哪里吗？
你们也是来找万叶的啊？看来他真的做了很了不起的事。
这次我们驾着小船来补充物资，结果刚进港就来了好多好多盗窃人，和我们打听万叶的事。要说之前明追滩那场战斗，大姐头也出了很多风头啊，我也没见大姐头有这么高的人气。在船队里，万叶的存在感不算强，有时候她还不听大姐头的话，但大姐头也不在意。哼，原来你还不知道她做了什么呀？
稍微听到了一些，比如挡下了雷电将军吴响的一刀之类的，那个很厉害吧？哦，这么解释的话，我一下子就理解了。<笑>那他这么受人追捧，也是应该的。 他早些时候被天领奉行的人叫走了，说是有重要的事情要和他谈。一开始我还以为是来抓人的呢，结果对方的态度特别友好，感觉他很受尊敬。
放在不久之前，根本完全无法想象。谢谢你啦，那我们去天领奉行府看看。
啊，我就在这边继续应付围观的人了。
嗯 ，something。In case.
The campaign begins.
Oopsies, wrong way. Oh, Kazuha!
Oh, it's you.
Greetings. We were just discussing the repealing of the Vision Hunt decree. Since you're here, you're very welcome to listen in on the conversation. We invited Mr. Kaidahara here to extend a gesture of goodwill on behalf of the Shogunate. Your hard work has secured for us the agreeable state of affairs that we now enjoy. Also, I've been granted the chance to correct my clan's past mistakes, and for that, I'm deeply grateful. The Almighty Shogun has issued a large array of directives aimed at resolving, or at least easing, the tensions that have built up over the years. The Tri-Commission has made the recommendation to use this opportunity to restore the honor of the Kaidahara name. Regarding the history of the Kaidahara clan, I trust that you're already somewhat informed?
Yes.
In short, there was once a group of select bladesmiths who served the Shogun directly, responsible for upholding and further developing the traditional blade forging arts of the Almighty Shogun. The Kaidahara clan belonged to this class. But there came a time when some of these bladesmiths revolted and fled to Snezhnaya. Both the Kaidahara and Kamisato clans were held accountable for lax oversight and entered a period of great turmoil. We later learned that the whole misadventure had been secretly orchestrated by the Fatui. Attributing all of the blame to the Kamisato and Kaidahara clans was neither proper nor just. Considering Mr. Kaidahara has once more made an outstanding contribution to Inazuma, the Almighty Shogun believes he should not only be rewarded for his achievements, but also receive recompense for the excessive punishment borne by his clan in the past. In the interest of preventing further harassment of the bladesmith clans by the Fatui, we chose not to publicly release the findings of our investigations into these matters. We trust you can understand why this was necessary.
This is a true honor. I'm delighted to be in a position to receive the goodwill of the Almighty Shogun and the Shogunate at large. However, would I be correct to assume that this magnanimous gesture does not come without some strings attached?
I can assure you that nothing could be further from the truth. We seek only to correct a past.
False.
With the Kaidahara clan's reputation and occupation restored, the Kaidaharas will be bladesmiths once more, and your wanderings will finally come to an end. You will be able to lead a safe and prosperous life in Inazuma City with the Almighty Shogun's blessing and full support of the Shogunate.
I have grown accustomed to life among the elements. I fear I would no longer feel at home behind the tall walls of a stately abode. Yet my ancestors did indeed take great pride in the name of Kaidahara, and the art of blade-making for which it stood. I do have a responsibility to restore their honor.
I sense some hesitation in your words. Should you accept this offer, I imagine many of the malicious rumors currently circulating through the populace will disappear.
Malicious rumors? All we heard on the way here was so much praise that we almost wondered whether there was another Kaidahara Kazuha in town.
Well, to some, the Musou no Hitotachi is something that can never be defeated. They cannot accept the idea that Mr. Kaidahara really parried the Shogun's strike. Also, eyewitnesses saw him using the power of Electro in addition to that of Anemo. As a result, the falsehood that Kaidahara Kazuha was using a delusion...
What? But that doesn't make sense. Using a
delusion... I mean, he has white hair.
That is correct. However, to some people, the idea of a single person wielding two elements at once is a more inconceivable notion still.
This is just one of many similar rumors. I am very uncomfortable with being the subject of public discussion, no matter whether it brings suspicion or stardom my way. But perhaps if the Shogunate is willing to publicly support me, this situation will blow over more quickly.
This is precisely why I encourage you to give our offer some serious thought. It stands to benefit all of us.
Please allow me some time to consider. In fact, let us put this discussion on hold for the moment. Well then, what brings the two of you here?
Yikes! We nearly forgot about the most important thing!
Weird voodoo guy with the voodoo sword.
Why would such a dangerous individual be looking for me? No. This puzzles me as much as it does you. My fighting forms were taught to me by my family, based on techniques originally developed for blade testing. We undergo rigorous training to standardize every motion the blade is put through, so that each can be fairly assessed for quality. Over time, these techniques came to form something of a Kaidahara sword art, focused on blade testing, but with a full repertoire of combat forms. Those forms are quite different from the more practical ones typically used by samurai in battle. So it's hard to imagine that the similarity you speak of was coincidence alone.
All the more reason to watch your back! This guy was a serious nutcase.
Indeed. He sounds highly aggressive. Anyone he targets is at risk of serious injury. Or worse.
In that case, I will send some men out immediately to search for him.
Thank you. I must say, I am now very curious about this matter, and I will also need some time to consider your offer. I will first join the Traveler in investigating the one who attacked her, then give you a conclusive answer upon my return.
Very well. Please stay safe.
Come on. Let's go and track down your aggressor.
Let's go!
The detective agency knows the most about what goes on in town. Let's see what Ryuji has to say.
Ryuji. What the hell? Oh, whoopsies. I could have teleported. Wait, where am I? What is this? Oh, hi, cat. Please, what is this?
Hey there! We'd like to ask you a quick question. Do you know if anyone around here has been looking for him? Kazuha, we mean.
Aha! So this is the renowned Mr. Kaidehara. I've heard a lot about you. It is an honor to finally meet you today.
You are too kind. We are currently investigating an assault and would appreciate any help you can offer.
Oh? You were targeted in an assault? Let me think. I can't seem to recall anything of immediate interest. Mr. Kaidehara is currently the talk of the town, so there are always a lot of people looking for him. To be honest with you, our detective agency has recently been receiving many inquiries from people wishing to obtain Mr. Kaidehara's personal information.
Hey!
Some of them are offering us millions of mora just to gather the information they want. If these were more legitimate commissions, Sango would have snapped them up in an instant.
Millions? Of mora?
Please, accept my thanks for looking out for my privacy.
Of course. No matter what, we only take on legitimate cases. We don't make our money by revealing details of other people's day-to-day life just for the sake of it. Sorry, I got a little off topic. What I'm really trying to say is, it doesn't surprise me that a complete stranger is looking for Mr. Kaidehara. But I wouldn't know where to begin if we want to connect this with an assault.
Then let's put that connection aside for now. Have there been any other attacks or similar incidents recently that stand out as particularly unusual? The Tenryo Commission had very few leads. I thought you might have some information from different sources.
It's true that the commissioners aren't clued up about every little thing that goes on out in the streets. But typically, it's only the most trivial events that manage to escape their attention. If anyone had been out there attacking people, that would be assault, in which case the Tenryo Commission would absolutely get involved.
That does make sense. Uh-oh. Looks like the trail's already run cold.
I still find it difficult to believe that whoever attacked you hasn't been causing any trouble elsewhere. Few people possess your prowess in battle. So unless you were the first person he targeted, someone is certain to have been hurt by now. I am well aware of your talents. There is no need to be humble around me. In fact, I'm quite relieved that you were the one he targeted. It would cause me great grief to see someone become critically injured or lose their life because of me. For the poor victim, this would be a completely senseless crime.
Don't worry, we'll find him.
It seems you are every bit the selfless hero they make you out to be, Mr. Kaidehara. Surely this same concern for your fellow man is what drove you to fearlessly raise your blade against the almighty Shogun.
You flatter me. Truth be told, I don't know quite what came over me in that moment.
You are much too humble.
You are much too humble.
I will try my best to gather whatever leads I can for you. Oh, actually, there was one strange incident over the last few days. It doesn't involve an attack, though. Let me tell you about it just in case.
Sure. During times like this, the more information we have, the better.
All right, then. Recently,
make it quick,
two people went missing from the city at around the same time. One of them is a pretty well-known collector, surnamed Nagato. The other, Amenoma Yuya, is a samurai from the Amenoma clan.
Amenoma! Now there's a familiar name!
Right. Yuya is the nephew of Amenoma Togo, the owner of Amenoma Smithy. Two grown men going missing at the same time. Their cases are likely connected, but I don't know much in the way of details. I recalled this because Amenoma Yuya is also an accomplished martial artist who is skilled with the blade. Perhaps he is the one you are looking for.
Understood, though it seems highly unlikely to me. I neither know this man, nor do I have any idea why he may wish to attack me.
Sure, can't hurt. We never know what we might find out along the way.
Thank you, Ryuji. We'll start by making some inquiries at the Amenoma Smithy.
Sounds good. All the best with your investigation. I'll get moving shortly myself.
If it isn't Kaede Harakazuha, what brings you here today?
Huh? You two know each other?
Yes. The Kaede Hara and Amenoma clans were both members of the Raiden Gokaden. Historically, there have always been deep links between the two clans. After I returned to Inazuma, I visited Mr. Amenoma to pay my respects. Yes. You may recall the story of the Raiden Gokaden from the Iridori Festival.
Though all bladesmiths trace their craft back to the same source, over time, each of us has arrived at a different blade-making philosophy, spawning the development of different branches of the same art. As an example, the Amenoma art strives to emulate the abiding patience and determination of water as it turns stone to sand. There is nothing mystical to our work. There is only practice, day in and day out, until both body and mind have memorized the craft, turning each motion of every technique into an intrinsic part of the bladesmith's life.
That explains.
As for the art of the Kaede Hara clan, I believe it's called the Ishin art.
That's right. Ishin art strives for complete harmony between blade and mind from the moment that forging begins. For only a blade thus forged can capture and convey its maker's thoughts and feelings, and eventually become an extension of its wielder's will.
Indeed. Most samurai choose their blades, but an Ishin blade chooses its owner.
Ooh.
You are, without a doubt, the most worthy wielder of an Ishin blade. It gladdens my heart to see that although the Kaede Hara clan has fallen on hard times, its ideals and virtues are alive and well.
You overestimate me. My actions are guided by my own personal sentiments, not by any noble aspirations on behalf of my clan. But let's get back on topic. The purpose of our visit today is to gather some information on your missing nephew. We hope to assist with the investigation. It may turn out that this case is connected to another we are pursuing.
Ah, yes. My nephew. I reported the case to the Tenryo Commission, but I haven't heard anything back so far. He didn't say a word before he left, which is very unlike him. I'm still completely at a loss on what to make of it, but I've done what I can so far. Worrying is futile. All I can do now is wait for the news from the Tenryo Commission.
We heard that there was a collector involved in the disappearance too. Know anything about that?
Yes. On the morning that Yuya went missing, he gave me a very cryptic look and said that he was going to give me a great gift. I believe he went to collect the item from Mr. Nagato after that. The next thing I heard was that a fire had broken out at the warehouse, and neither of them came back. Yes. Strange, isn't it? I wonder what could have caused it. Unfortunately, there was very little evidence left behind, so nobody knows what really happened.
Do you have any thoughts on what Yuya may have wanted to give you?
If I had to guess, it must have been some kind of rare weapon. Otherwise, there would have been no reason for him to get my hopes up. He's never been particularly interested in blade forging, but has always had a fondness for blade testing, and can sense even the most minute differences in blade quality. He is extraordinarily talented in martial arts, particularly when it comes to the art of the sword.
Truth be told, we have some information that you may find to be objectionable. The person we are looking for, he attacked this friend of mine. Based on the evidence we have gathered so far, only Yuya seems to match the suspect's profile.
What? No. Absolutely impossible. Yuya is not that kind of person. He is humble and kind. Even his training is done with the goal of calming his mind. He has never gotten into a fight before.
Is that so?
Yes. If there's one thing I can say for certain, it's that Yuya would never draw his blade without a very good reason. But, with that said, it's equally out of character for him to just disappear, with neither farewell nor fair warning. I also cannot know what course of action he might be capable of if coerced or otherwise compelled by circumstances unbeknownst to me. Anyway, should you find him, please let me know as soon as possible.
Don't worry. You have our word.
From the sound of that, Paimon doesn't think Yuya was the one who attacked us as well.
Yes. It sounds as if something happened when the two men met each other. Let's pay a visit to the Nagato household.
I think that's it for me today. I shall finish this tomorrow night, I think. Yeah, I'll finish this quest tomorrow. So, I'm gonna stop the stream here. Good night! Bye, stream! Whoever's watching!